hardest thing about being old is remembering being young. Continuing to try and catch up on overdue commissioned reviews, commissioned through the Patreon right there. You can commission your own review if you got something you want me to see or read or what have you. This one is a movie I've known about for quite a while because the Oscars for the year that it came out. It came out in 99. So the Oscars that were held in 2000 were the first Academy Awards I actually like paid attention to and watched. So I remember it being up for several awards, and it's always stuck in my head, possibly only for that reason. But this is The Straight Story, which is really difficult to describe, especially once I tell you who directed it. Hold on, I'll get there. Those of you who already know, shh, don't tell them. So this is a true story about a guy who is in his 70s, a guy named Alvin Strait, and he's not in great shape. He has trouble getting around. He can't see very well. He doesn't have a driver's license because he's not allowed to drive any longer. And he finds out that his brother, who he's been estranged from for a very long time, has had a stroke. And so what Alvin then proceeds to do is to get on a riding mower and drive that 5-mile-an-hour riding mower across multiple states over the course of 6 weeks so that he can go and see his brother. Now, there's obviously, here's the thing. If you're the kind of person who's immediately going, well, why didn't he take the bus? Why didn't somebody else drive him? Why didn't he fly? If those are the kinds of questions you're immediately asking in anything other than, I wonder what the reason is, this might not be the movie for you. And the reason is, he's a stubborn old guy. He wants to get himself there. He doesn't like being driven around by other people. He can't drive a car himself. He has a mower. That's how he's going to get out there. He is a feverishly stubborn and willful old guy, but also not a grouch. You'd think that, certainly in terms of the stereotypes of older characters, that, you know, he'd just be so pig-headed and, get out of my way, and like, no, he's not. He's a nice, very stubborn old guy. And he wants to do it himself. And when I said you may not know what to expect once you hear who directed it, this is a David Lynch movie. And it is the least Lynchian movie that David Lynch ever made. It is missing almost every signature of the man's entire filmography. There's no dreamscapes. There's no dream logic. There's no sort of rotting underbelly under the facade of Americana. None of that. It's just a story about a guy riding a mower to see someone in his family before it's too late. That's the movie. It really is kind of unspoilable because I can't really spoil for you what happens on the road. Nothing happens. I say nothing, like, things happen. He stops, he has conversations with people. There are scenes, but like nothing extraordinary happens on the road. The fact that he takes this trip is the extraordinary thing. The trip in and of itself doesn't need to be any more extraordinary than that. And the film treats it that way. It's actually very, very weird for me to try and talk about this movie. Because I liked it, and I was really engaged by it. And I'm not sure what Lynch does in this that makes it grab me in a way that when I've tried to watch these kinds of slice of life films before, I zone out. I zone out a lot, but I don't hear, and I'm not entirely sure why. Some of it may honestly be superficial details. Really, the only person in my own life who I knew well, who had a riding mower, was my grandfather, who doesn't bear a whole lot of resemblance to Alvin, and yet I kept finding myself thinking of my grandfather. And maybe that's part of it. I think a lot of it just has to do with an absolutely astounding performance from Richard Farnsworth, who plays Alvin, who there's just an honesty to everything about this performance, which there's a reason it comes across that way. The fact that he has to move around with canes and he is so stiff and has so much trouble standing, that's not an act. Richard Farnsworth had cancer in his bones when he was filming this. He was that stiff. It was that hard for him to get around. The weight of a life of experience, the wisdom and the softness from somebody who has seen a lot but hasn't let it turn him hard. That's just something that he brings to this part. And there is such sincerity to it that he's so sweet. And so the little moments where his stubbornness flares up in this very mundane way, usually when he is talking to someone and he knows he's about to say something that they're not going to like, whether it be because he's about to turn down somebody's offer to drive him the rest of the way because he wants to finish the journey the way he started it, or whether it be because he's pointing out that a couple of mechanics who did a little repair work on his mower shouldn't be charging him what they're charging him. And he's just very polite, but very firm. And he kind of, through sheer stubbornness, gets his way. Not in a way that, like, things are just handed to him. It's not easy. None of it's easy. But he's too stubborn to not do it. So he's gonna do it. And he's just going to keep moving forward at 5 miles an hour. The scene that got me choked up, though, I know was because of my grandfather. There's a scene later in the movie where Alvin is talking to another guy. And, like, they don't know each other. But there's work being done on the mower, and this guy knows how far Alvin's come and just wants to, you know, sit down, talk with him. And they're both World War II veterans. My grandfather was a World War II veteran. And listening to the two of them talk about how haunted they were by that experience, and to hear particularly Alvin tell a story that you get the very distinct feeling he hasn't told before. And it's not like it suddenly changes the movie to become about, you know, the failure to honor what is commonly referred to as the greatest generation or anything like that. No, it's just another moment of this man on a journey connecting with somebody. And the fact that it's called the Straight Story, I mean, Straight was the guy's last name. Again, Alvin Straight was real. This did happen. And the Straight Story is both a descriptor of who it's about, but also the nature of it. There's no embellishment, really. There's no flourish. It just is. You're just along for this very slow ride that has stakes, but really only for one person. And you can't help but just be happy to be riding along. It's one of those movies that I know it's good, but trying to explain why it's good is almost impossible. I looked a little bit into the behind the scenes, and there was something that I found out that I think might be the best way for me to try and encapsulate this film. When this was released to DVD, on the request of David Lynch, the director, there's no chapter selection option. Because Lynch was very firm about the fact that this movie is meant to be taken in its entirety in one go continuously. And he did not want to give people the ability to jump to later points or to skip parts. And A, he was right, and B, that feels like, just as a vibe, a better summation of the film than I'm ever going to manage to do. For want of some degree of criticism, Sissy Spacek plays Alvin's daughter, adult daughter, but who has, it's never identified firmly what it is, but she has some degree of learning or cognitive difficulty. It's not labeled in any specific way. And I don't want to go on this too harshly because I didn't see at least what, from my perspective as someone who lacks in those kinds of disabilities and has never had to deal with them, I watch her performance and I feel like it lacks a lot of the bad stereotyping, cliches, or over-the-top performances that come from a neurotypical person playing someone who's neurodivergent or in some way developmentally disabled. So while it certainly avoids the kind of performance that feels like mockery, I don't feel comfortable saying that it's a 100% accurate or tasteful performance, simply because it's not, I'm not the person who could or should ever make that call. I would say that, and definitely for 1999, at the time it came out, like, it's not the kind of bad you would expect from that kind of character being played in a movie at that point in time. But I am still going to put a mild asterisk on it, if seeing that kind of depiction, especially if you yourself either have any of those impairments or people close to you do, I don't know how respectful the portrayal is. To me, it felt like it was, but ultimately, that's not my call. That's really kind of the only thing that I could even come vaguely close to a criticism on. And even there, it's more like, if someone else is going to criticize this, I'm not going to dispute them, as opposed to something that I'm actually going to criticize. It's just a pleasant and oddly touching film. Yeah. The Straight Story. Did you ever see it? Whatever your thoughts are, drop something down in the comments. Let's talk about it. Like, share, subscribe. They'll help me out. I already mentioned the Patreon. I'll mention it again. But you don't have to do any of that. Take a relaxed attitude around here so you can just come on back next time you need a break.